Ready? Hi, I'm Myron Scheinhouse, and I know Ogenus since 1978. So, Lewis, we're tied. 35 years. But my story actually starts before I met Ogenus. In 1972, I woke up one morning after eating double Mac hamburgers, and I just had this revelation. And the revelation was, why am I eating cooked foods? No animal on the planet cooks their food. It doesn't make any sense. And from that morning on, I just started and launched on a program of eating raw foods. And 6 years later, I was dating a girl who was working at Aunt Tilly's, Janet Ford. Did you know her?
Yes.
And she knew about my diet, and she said, do you know Ogenus? And I said, who? And she said, Ogenus, he eats raw foods too. And I said, no, I never heard of him. So we were going out for a few months, and she kept seeing that I was very serious about eating raw foods. And she said, you should meet Ogenus. So finally, after 4 months, I said, well, when am I going to meet this Ogenus guy? And she said, how about right now? So she took me over to his house that night, and I met Ogenus. He was walking around barefoot, and I later learned that he always walked barefoot to build up his blood and make it thicker. And he and I became very good friends from that moment on. We spent a lot of time together. We roller skated together. We shared a lot of experiences together. And Paul, where's Paul? I think it was a red Audi that he was. He was always working on this Audi.
I just remember him always, you know, in later years, it was always, don't let your skin touch anything. I have a picture I'm searching for of him head to toe in grease. Head to toe underneath that car doing it himself.
I used to crawl under the car with him on many occasions. Organic grease, yeah. Well, it's another kind of fat. But my favorite story about Ogenus, and I've been through thick and thin with Ogenus and his girlfriends and his trials and tribulations, but I was on a raw food vegetarian diet, and I was very skinny. I was about 125 pounds. And one day, after a few years of hanging out with Ogenus, I said, Ogenus, I'm really unhappy with my diet. I'm skinny. I like to do athletic things. I like to run, but I can't regenerate. And he said to me, well, you need to eat raw meat. I said, but I'm a vegetarian. I don't eat meat. He said, well, you should try some raw meat. I said, no. I said, you're going to kill me if I eat raw meat. It'll, you know, I'll die. He said, look, Myron. He got up right in my face. I mean, literally right in my face, nose to nose. And he looked me dead in the eye. And he said, Myron, you've tried every other frickin' diet in the world. He used another F word, actually. You use your imagination. He said, just try it. And I said, Ogenus, my death is going to be on your conscience. Because I'm going to die. I haven't touched meat or you know, any kind of flesh protein in 10 years. And he said, do it. I said, okay, all right, but remember. So I left Ogenus' house that moment, and I went to Bristol Farms, and I looked at the meat counter, and I picked the Spencer steak, and I said, would you grind that for me, please? And he said, you want to grind a $16 a pound steak? And I said, yes. And he ground the steak, he looked at me like I was a weirdo, and I felt like a weirdo, and he ground the steak, put it in this brown paper wrapping, and I went home that night. And I unraveled the brown paper wrapping, and I looked at it, this dead piece of flesh that I was so against, and I said, Myron, this is the strangest thing you've ever done in your life. And in that moment, I tasted this raw, dead flesh. And I put it in my mouth, and I said, hey, that's not so bad. And so I ate half of this. And I sat down, and I prepared myself to die. Literally, I thought I was going to go into convulsions. I saw myself writhing on the floor in seizures. And this is what I expected to happen. And because I wanted to prove Agenis wrong. This was my goal. So I did it on a dare. Because I knew he was wrong. And I sat down, and I'm very sensitive to my body, so I watched my body. And I just closed my eyes, and a half an hour went by, and I said, hey, I feel fine. So I ate the other half of this this dead piece of flesh. And that night I went to sleep. I had the best sleep I ever had in my life because I was insomniac before this. And then I was like, all of a sudden, I just fell asleep. And I woke up the next morning and my battery was like completely recharged. I felt like a new person. And that was 1984. And I've been eating raw meat ever since. And I am so thankful to Agenis. Agenis was my friend. He was always available to me, no matter what the crisis was, no matter what the emergency was, no matter how many times I called him, and I called him a lot. And he was always patient and tolerant and kind and generous and warm and giving. And he was a real friend, and he was my mentor. He taught me everything. He taught me about biochemistry. He taught me about how the body works. He taught me about alkaline and acid foods. He taught me about don't take medicine. Every time I said, oh, I'm gonna take this medication. No, don't take any medication. Let your body heal itself. I said, really? He said, yes, your body will heal itself. Just give it the opportunity to do it, and it will do it. So I listened to him, because he sounded like he knew what he was talking about. And he was always right, always right. And my body would heal itself. Just give it the chance. And Agenis saved my life, and he will always be my hero, and I'm always very thankful to him, and I can't believe he's not with us, although he is with in spirit, and I agree, but I will miss him dearly. He was a very, very good friend of mine. Thank you.